kuulira malobozi mu nyumba ngoyatula nti great is the Lord. Bible yayogera negamba nti Katonda waffe wa kitiibwa, and he deserves to be greatly praised. He's a great God and he deserves your great praise. Just raise up your voice right now. Declare something. Leko wengula buulire. Leke mpewe ulire. Leke mikwetolo tebi ulire. Ntikachonda wa mani. Ntikachonda wa buiza. Tiyo yala kila chive ne chiva. Yo yali wakulu wa bulimbela. Yo yali wakulu wa buli wakabaka. Ngane bakabaka mubichiwa byabwe bafunama. Ngane bakaka mubukaka byabwe bafunama. Ngane bichonde byonna bifunama. We worship you, Jesus. We glorify your name. For there is no one like you. There is no one like you, Jesus. Teli no mwalinga kwe. Weka chonde ya chonda. Ojuta magezi no kutegela. Ebi ebita sowala kutegele wa mwana wa muntu. Amagezi agakatambu zomu sayi misu wajafe. Weka chonda manyomu wendo kwenviri ezi tulikumitwe. Weka chonda tumanya manya. Oh Jesus. We glorify you. We glorify you, Abba Father. We glorify you, Ancient of Days. We glorify you, the great I am. We glorify you, Alpha and Omega. We glorify you, consuming fire. We glorify you, the rock of ages. We glorify you, El Shaddai. We glorify you, Adonai. We glorify you. There is none like you, Lord. Ako kabonero kakulaga kitiibwa eri Katonda. Waliwo ebiseera bye tumala ne tuwa abantu ekitiibwa. Naye kano akadde ka Katonda. Labanga buli kyonna ekiri ku gwe kimuwa ekitiibwa. Labanga buli kyonna ekiri ku mubiri gwe kikkiriza. Gatuvunamawo wali. Oyo Katonda w'ekitiibwa w'entiisa. Osanite. Tuvunama ku nnamulondo y'enkya ya leero. Gatuzze n'okusinza. Tuyingira mu mpya zo n'okusinza. Tuyingira mu mpya zo nga tuyimba. Tugamba osanite. Jesus, oh yes, you are worthy of my praise. Oh, you are worthy of my praise. Jesus, oh yes, you are worthy of my praise. Jesus. There is no one like you, oh God. There is no one like you, Jehovah Jireh. Tell him, Ulala Yafa. Tell him, Ulala Yakubi Wamiko. okuchokoyo mwana gwendiga oye yele sebe tiwa nabire kayo byo nabyo namukulu. We are still continuing with the same song as we bless the name of the Lord, as we bless the name of the Lord. Oh Jesus, you are worthy of my praise. Oh, you are worthy of my praise. I want to hear our voices as we sing. Everybody raise up your hands.
You are the worthy of my praise. Oh,
lekoye musedo boziryo namanyi gogona.
Oh,
we say
Jesus, you are worthy of my praise.
Tukiriza nti teri mulala asaanidde kusinza kwaffe. Tukiriza nti teri mulala kwetu navunamira. Declare it again and say, Jesus,
Jesus,
oh,
you are worthy of my praise.
Oh,
you are worthy of my praise.
Oh, say, Jesus,
Jesus,
you are worthy
of my praise.
Lord, hear us as your people. We declare. No one else is worthy of the glory. Hey, everybody join in and say, Jesus. Hey, we worship you, Lord. Chali chisache. tuyimba empola nga tugamba nti
kyali kisa mu biro bye nalumwanga kyali kisa
mu biro nga sirina njagala
kyali kisa
Somebody give God the praise. Somebody give God the honor. Somebody give God the praise. He deserves it. He deserves it. Somebody just wave to the Lord. He will send me connection to my woman. Come and shout it to Sancho. Vale Manigo. Shout it to Sancho. She got that to Sancho.
Oh, oh, oh. One more time with our hands lifted up, Chalichisa. Chalichisa. Great and mighty God. Under the mighty hand. In the provision of grace. We humble ourselves before you. Committing our lives into your hands. And exclusively the lives of the little ones. Those that are here, even those who are not here, but they are part of us. Bless them and bless them indeed. Bless the sessions that are coming on. The ministers, the facilitators, the teachers. Let everything go to work, operate under the mighty hand of God. To bring about the divine impartation that we need. In the name of Jesus. And God's people say amen.
Amen.
If you can give a clap offering to the Lord.
Amen.
You can take your seats. Let us clap for our heroes as they march to their respective place. Choir, Irene, Komawe Mabega. Bahiros, Chamanyete wabategede, nabadde ntegeeza bano.
They match out first and what we are calling them is what they are supposed to be.
Because with our mouth we create. Okay, now let us appreciate our champions. God bless everybody. God bless the choir, mass choir, musicians, everybody doing a great work here. Please give them a hand.
Come abom, saba mass choir, bakwaya, bakube bivuga. Buliye na ina chakula wakulu anumba kubide komungalo.
And again, I want us to appreciate all the ministers, the intercessors who come here earlier, even the ushers who work even a day earlier or before, and all the ministers in the various departments, please let us appreciate them with a hand clap.
God bless
all of you. In a special way, I want to welcome each and every one of you in the house of the Lord. Basically, or to begin with the visitors who have come to visit us for your very first time. Can we see your hands just for special recognition?
Katulabe kumukono gwo na fetu kwa nilize. Amen.
God bless you. Did you manage to greet us before now?
Watubuziza konga chinote chinabao?
Not yet. If you don't mind, please shout your name and let us know where you come from.
Wabanga tofude nyo erinyero lireka nilao woli tuliwulire.
Around here. You are much welcome, please. Abaloko le tukube mungalunga, batuku vunga basatu wa mungu watila. Hey, kose chali yo COVID. Okay. You are much welcome. We normally hug, but there is a threat of the pandemic, so let us extend our love in remote.
Kutero kugwa mbufuba na yolo kwa wachari woka COVID.
Amen.
Amen.
Again, we want to welcome a few faces, some people who have taken long, like Mama Talimba. It's been some time. Yeah, Sundays. I'm talking of Sundays.
Mama Talimba.
Sunday.
Mama Talimba.
Nze mwaniriza. And then I see a few students here. Brian Mulabyenge Kirevuchikuze to whoop it over Brian.
Brian.
No, na kuli maso sebo na watu whoop it up. We kakasolwali don't you vote on and take a derinya yo.
Make sure you leave.
And even the queen is around now to whoop it up. Yes, I don't know whether they have had their holiday officially or they are here on what occasion, but we see them in the church. So we want to welcome all of
students.
Okay. We are happy to see each and every one of you. And again, we are sorry. I've just seen a note on the platform that I don't miss a message. The family of Rukwago, their kid has broken a leg. I don't know exactly. I saw it briefly because I was rushing to church. Any information of that kind?
Is it Mr. and Mrs. Rukwago?
Yes, I saw. I saw a post on the church family platform. There is a fractured leg, a boy, or being dressed. It's not theirs. Okay, no problem. Never mind. God is in control.
Katonda afuga.
Amen. We want to appreciate the work of God going on here in prayer and fasting, commitment, and all the devotions done in the house of God.
Twagala nnyo okwebaza olw'ekigenda maaso mu nyumba ya Mukama, okusiiba n'okusaba ate n'okwewaayo mu nyumba ya Mukama.
I will highly appreciate the efforts of Pastor Jenny, Pastor Stephen, and the elders Basut and other senior ministers who are actively involved in these programs.
Njagala nnyo okwebaza okusingira ddala Omusumba Jenny, Omusumba Kayanja, abakadde n'abaweereza abenyigidde mu kusaba okwo.
I'm very sure the Lord is taking us.
Ndi mukakafu nnyo nti Katonda alina watutwala.
From one place, from one level to another level.
Okuva mu kifo ekimu okugenda mu kifo ekirala.
So whatever you've put your hand to do in the work of God.
Buli kyonna ky'oteekako emikono gyo okukola nga mulimo gwa Katonda.
Take the advice Jesus spoke of one time to his disciples. That once you hold a hoy, that refers to a tool of ministry or instrument of service. Don't even think of looking behind. Because everything that you hold on to move forward in God, it will always lead you to success. So I know we are moving on. Let us give glory to God in the name of Jesus. I want us to share the word of God this morning and then we shall pray.
Njagala tugabane ekigambo kya Katonda amakya ga leero era bwe tunaamaliriza tunaasaba.
I'll do a few minutes and then invite Pastor Jane to lead us into a session of prayer of about 10 to 15 minutes.
Nja kukozesaawo eddakiika ntonotono nyanirize Omusumba Jane atukulembere mu ssaala eyaddakiika 10 ku ddakiika 15.
Because I want the flow of prayer to continue.
Banga twagala okulukuta kw'essaala kweyongere maaso ne ku lunaku olw'e Sunday.
I am so happy to the Lord who is raising up here people, ministers, and the, you know, many men and women of God that are showing up now, some maturity in Christ.
Ndi musanyufu nnyo olwa Katonda lw'abantu abo bagenze ayimusa mu kifo kino mu buweereza nga bakola omulimu mu ngeri ya bukulu nga bakukolera Kristo.
The other day, I think, was it women when Rebecca and Marcy ministered? That was women.
Waliwo mugwo kutano abachala bali baweereza muchala muhima ne Marcy rebayimirira okuweereza mu kigambo.
And I think it was in June, the first week, when the young people, the youth of this church, organized an event which was very, very, very powerful.
Era munaku z'omwezi 18 abavubuka b'ekifo kino bateekateeka olukuŋŋaana oluhali olw'amaanyi ddala.
And last Sunday it was the married people.
Ate Sunday ewedde kyali ky'abafumbo.
And they also blessed the church tremendously.
Ate era nabo baawera ddala ekkanisa.
So when I'm sitting down and I see things happening like that, I can't fail to give thanks to the Lord.
Bwe mba ntudde wansi nendaba ebintu nga bigenda mu maaso bwe bityo sisobola kulemererwa kuddiza Katonda kitiibwa.
Because I have a mind of discipleship.
Kubanga munda munze ninamu ondowoza eyokusitula abayigirizwa.
My joy is to see other people rising.
Esanyu lyange kwe kulaba abantu abalala nga bayimuka.
Doing something that I should be doing, even when they're doing it much better than me.
Nga bakola ekintu kye nandibadde nkola ate nga bakikola n'okunsinga.
So if I can see that happening in the house of God, I give glory to God. Last Sunday, Mr. Galabuzi stood here to preach.
Sunday wedde, Mwami Galabuzi yayimirira wano okubuulira.
He posed a theme or a heading which surprised me so much.
Because
I had that topic some time back until I knew it was married day, but that's the topic I was going to share if that Sunday I was to preach.
Kubango mutogo, nalina gufuna da, na ye ne mpulidanti lunakula abafumbo, ne ngutereka na esinga, naliwa kuimilida Sunday wede, when nalingendo kubuli lako.
When he stood here, that's the topic he announced.
Kwea imilida wano, kwe mutogo njini kwea rangi lida.
Do you still remember his head?
Mujukiro mutwe kweyawa.
Anybody who was here last Sunday?
Waliwe yaliwa Sunday wetengo kujukira. Musimenta huyo.
Musimenta ya gamba atia. Oyote yali mwami galabuzi.
Oyo yali mwami
senfuma. Atoyo yali mwami senfuma. Mwami galabuzi obatabu dene senfuma. Cha senfuma tebache ilabila cha kuata yon. Aha, cha mwami galabuzi katiche mbabuza.
Mwami galabuzi ya bulida msekend service.
Babu ulizi. Mwami galabuzi. Ero muntu amchidamu ato kukubanga yaliwo eranga ya muu uliriza. Bameka abaliwo that day. And how many of you heard him?
Because
it's one thing to be there and also to hear a preacher preaching.
Uyinzo kuba wana inauta ulida
mungu. Kati, kati who want to gini venangi. Ababubu kaba taa vasoma. Memoriza mmezicha akola. Obobu simu basimu the windows.
Please uuli ajukira.
Njagala umumano mtototo. Abaka debawa ni kemikona abatumu mwenamu untu nulira. What was the heading? Irene now. Don't lose your faith. Ne chintu cheyo gerache njini njini.
Na egwe gwali omutwe msumba. Tosula kukiliza.
Ngaba cha wakana. Ochogede muruzungu muruganda. Muruzungu yogede otia. Don't lose your faith in that. Tatugama nga kodo don't lose your faith. Wamasi. Kati abakade wama tununule. Ebiso mozo kukiliza. Aniyo mwala kati sefuma tunungo osago sembayo. Ah, kati pastor ya abanunule. Exactly, Pastor Jenny yensonga yachi ye mchala lule, ereye pastor we chacheno. Cast not away your confidence.
Tosula bugumubo.
That's what the man said.
Echo msajja chia yokira.
Kati mujukide. Panange. Fefe kama tula wali fetu awuli na wetu tiyo. Now, when he said that, that was a topic I had already some time back, and I thought that would be a Sunday stand here to preach.
Gwe mutwe gwe nalina akasera kaiseke mabegeranga manyiwe na imilia Sunday wede.
So I knew there would be a scripture he will not miss.
Namanya ntualuwe chawandikwa chatajja kusubwa.
What shocked me, he never mentioned that scripture at all.
Echasingo kunewu njisa, echawandikwa chote ya chogu.
And for sure, even the approach to the topic went a different direction.
Erane ngeri jea yogera mungu mutogo ya kuogera kumu ngeri ya njau.
But the content and the matter differed all lot with mine or from mine.
Na ye, nebye ya yogera kuo,
which means my message was spared to today. But under the same topic. Give glory to God in the name of Jesus. We are going to talk in about 15 to 25 minutes about holding on to your confidence. Same as cast not away your confidence. Cast not away your confidence as a believer. Cast not your confidence away as a child of God.
Gwengo mwana wakatonda tosula buvumubo.
Allow me to tell you, you've got potential to become somebody great. You know, every time I try to think about God,
whom I can't see anytime I want to see him, but I just know he is.
You always
wonder how he came up with the science of making man.
And how
he chose to be in a state of the spirit.
And he made
man and gave him three parts. The body, which is
physical.
The soul, which is in between.
And
then the spirit, which is an entire being, which is a complete
being. And
that spiritual resembles God.
But
how he is eternal also amazes me.
You see, there
are some things you must, whether you like or not, at least imagine of God.
If you will
ever also endeavor to know who you are.
Because
it is absurd for man to fail to know at least a little amount of who we are.
Kubanga chanaku nyo, omuntu yenna kubanga tasobola kumanyako wadde akatundu akecho kyali.
By virtue of him who made us.
Olwoyo yatukola.
And the information that we have that he made us resembling him.
Ateno kumanya kwetu inanti yatukola nga tumufanana.
There are attributes of God that I look to.
Waliwo ebintu bya Katonda byentunulira.
And I start to fear myself as well.
Nange nentandika okwetya.
The one man who tried to explain that is called David. I think he took time to think about God. And then he said, but who is man? That God, you will be mindful of him. You made him a little lower than angels. But you have given him power to dominate creation. So in another area he said, for I am fearfully and wonderfully created. In other words, David said, I cannot even understand myself. Because I'm fearfully and wonderfully created. If you have a little background of that kind, you will not find it so difficult to understand some of the things we are going to share. Because in that way, man is not limited. You are not limited to that black structure in which you appear physically. In fact, what you are outside is so little and temporal. You are more than that primary liver. You are more than that villager in the deepest of the village.
You are
a child of God. A co-heir with the Christ. A loyal generation. A loyal priesthood and a loyal generation. As I speak to you right now, you have a potential to become somebody great. You can become a talk of the town and the city. You can be a champion of the champions. You can be above and on top. If you have some little strength, say amen. You know, the reason why you look at me even as I speak those things, it is because so much has, which is not you, has been spoken to you. Everything has tried to explain and to define you. We've allowed to have voices of things and the people who know nothing about us to talk to us. And even the gospel We have not taken our real gospel most of the time. Out of 100, the gospel that addresses us in reality, we've taken many times 20%. But if we take the entire gospel, what does Paul say? For the gospel, gospel is power. Every time you sit under something called the gospel, you are seated under potential power. Power to do what? Power to change. I don't know what you are thinking about, but every time I am exposed to power, I'm hungering for something that can deal with my situation. If I come weak and I sit under power, I need that power to strengthen me. So that's why every time you come here, we do not address your current situation. Because the gospel is for the transformation to change somebody from bad to good, from poverty to riches, from sickness to wealth, to health. And that's what you are becoming now in the name of Jesus. Amina. So cast not away your confidence. Let us read Hebrews 10:35. That's the verse I thought Mr. Garabuzi was going to begin with. And we'll finish with 39. If you are there, say amen.
Gatugendo some byabandikibwa abeplani yesula 10 olunyiriri olwasatu mu 5 bobanga otuseyo gamba nti amina kale mungoberere kale temusula nga bugumu bwamwe obuliko empeere nnene kubanga mwetaaga okugumiikiriza bwe muli mala okukola Katonda byayagala mulyoke muweebwe ekyasuubizibwa kubanga wakyasigaddeyo akaseera katono nnyo ajja alituka so talirwa naye omutuukirivu wange aliba mulamu lwa kukkiriza era bw'addayo ennyuma emmeme yange temusanyukira olwasatuma omwenda naye ffe tetuli baakuda nnyuma mu kuzikirira naye tuli baakukkiriza okw'okulokola obulamu.
Can we say amen?
Tugambe nti amina.
Shout amen and I hear you.
Kirekana amina.
Okay, let us now come to Hebrews chapter 4.
Katika tudde mu kitabo kyekimu ekyo Abebulaniya esula nya
14 to 16.
Olunyiri wa 14 paka ku 16. Kale bwe tulina bakabona, bwe tulina kabona asinga obukulu omunene eyayita mu ggulu, Yesu mwana wa Katonda, tunywezenga okwatula kwaffe.
15.
Kubanga tetulina kabona asinga obukulu atayinza kulumirwa wamu naffe mu bunafu bwaffe. Naye yakemebwa mu byonna. Naye eyakemebwa mu byonna bumu ngaffe, so nga ye talina kibi. Kale tusembererenga n'obuvumu eri entebe y'ekisa, tulyoke tuweebwe okusasulwa era tufune ekisa olw'okubeerwa bwe kwetaaga.
Can we say amen?
Tugambe nti amina.
Take our seats quickly.
Tutuleko mangu mangu.
Cast not away your confidence,
tosula bugumu bwo,
which has got a great reward of recompense.
Obuliko empeera ennene.
Some translations put it that way.
Aba enzivunula ezimu zikyogera bwekitu.
But others say, therefore do not cast away your confidence,
endala zigamba n'olwekyo tosula bugumu bwo,
which has got a great reward,
obuliko empeera ennene.
But what I want to say this morning,
naye kyenjagala okwogera amakya ga leero,
confidence is an ingredient you need
obugumu kye kirungo kye weetaaga ekkubo lyo olifuula eriyitamu mbulamu singa omala n'osuula obugumu bwo oba onootera okufiira olutalo
the victory. Confidence is a key element in the mind of the achievers. Now, what is confidence? You know, when I was coming, most of the time when I give you definitions of some words, I don't check in the Oxford dictionaries. Because every language that you know, you can define the words in those languages. So all my definitions are called according to Edward translations. And what is confidence according to Edward translation? But you can check also in your Oxford dictionary if you have one.
Obugumu kye ki okusinziira ku nnyinnyonnyola y'omusumba Edward naawe osobola okukikebera
confidence
obugumu
is that level of trust
kwekwesiga okwo okweddaala ery'okwesiga
beyond reasonable doubt
erisukulumya okubuusabuusa.
Can we do it again? What is confidence?
Obugumu kye ki?
Confidence is that level of trust beyond reasonable doubt. When you trust something and you don't have any more doubt about it, or you trust somebody and you can't doubt them anymore, that turns into confidence you have in them. So when he talks about our confidence in God, he's talking about that trust in God, which is beyond any shadow of doubt. So every believer who will make it in a Christian life must have that confidence in God. Where you know that God is for real and everything is not. Where you know that God is well able to do it according to his riches in glory through Christ Jesus. Even when it seems impossible, I trust that God is well able to do it. Even when it is a gone case, I still trust God can bring it back to life. That's the confidence element every believer should have. It is the one Paul is speaking about in Hebrews, that do not cast it away. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you something here. The devil is willing to pay any price if he can buy away your confidence. The devil will do whatever it takes to take away that confidence in you. He will do it friendly if you can give it to him. But if you cannot, he can even turn violent in order to take it away. If you cannot, he will deploy even agents, if possibly your neighbors, anything or anybody, because you are so dangerous as long as you hold on to your confidence. People who are holding on to their confidence, you can never shake them, you can never turn them, You can never change them. They will hold on to their confidence until they achieve what they want. Now it is much more when it comes to the things of God. Because the truth is, Christian life is not a slope down. Once in a while, things will turn bitter. Once in a while, the storm will ravage. Once a while, there might be wars and battles and things that you cannot interpret on your human level. Things turning against you in every corner. But can I show you something? Life is just like that. I was briefly talking to Pastor Stephen. And we are wondering why in agriculture, in crop farming, most of the crops have pests. And most of these seeds come from abroad. Do you know something that you even hate to whisper? That all these seeds that are brought on market, they come with the corresponding pests. The makers of the seeds, the makers of the seeds also create pests. So that they can sell pesticides. What a funny thing. But when you look at life, that's exactly the pattern. Where you find the good things, even the bad things will be there. We all enjoy light, but please, brother, as you enjoy light, wait for darkness to also set in. Things go by two. Now I touched my head and said, what is the meaning of this? Then I realized it's the reason why we have mind. God made us to be managers. You see, if there is nothing you are managing around, you are going to be down and down. What will be the difference between you and the machine? So partly the reason why we have a lot to sort is because we are managers. Because when the challenge comes in, it prompts you to think. People who don't shy away from problems, they are made better for every problem they confront to solve. I'm told Israel is very powerful. Not because they are built with the muscles, but it's because of the surrounding enemies who are attacking all the time. When you look at the Western countries, the white people, they are so far advanced than the black people. But when you go to their countries, you realize that they have worse and harsh conditions than we have in Africa. So part of the reason why they have advanced, they have a lot to think about and to work on. So, come to Christian life. It is amazing, it is wonderful. But it is also confronted. Yes, the devil is so real. As you receive true God, the true enemy will attack you. But the good news that I have, God is always greater than any power, than any devils. Somebody say hallelujah. Actually, whenever the devil comes in reality, God will also arise in reality. When the demon spirits of the devil come against you, emizimu eja sultani bwejimala nejikulumba. The spirit of God upon you. Omoyo wa Katonda ali kukwe. Will overcome every evil spirit in the name of Jesus. Ajakuwangula buli moyo mubi muli nyera Yesu. That's why as a child of God. Yesu angalwa chigwengo mwana wa Katonda. You need to have your confidence in God. Otekeddwa okubeera n'obugumu bwo mu Katonda. No matter the circumstance, no matter the situation. Sinsonga mbeera cheze sinsonga bizibu chebikujide. Paul in this first part of Hebrews 10. Paul is talking to the believers about enduring hardship, about suffering shame as a believer. You know, when you talk good about your God, when you talk you give testimonies what God has done. People are waiting when anything will come, anything wrong, so that they begin to ask you, where is your God? Where was he when you are losing your business? Look at your business. Look at your family. Look at your ministry. Look at your life. Where is God? Now, in most cases, that is the time many people become ashamed to declare loudly or openly the name of their God, because they fear to suffer the challenge. But Paul is telling us, no matter what you are going through, don't cast away your confidence. Keep your confidence. Even when you are down, be confident that one day I am going to arise. I'll step back and I will continue. Even when you have nothing today, don't cast away your confidence in our God of provision, because it is a matter of time. He will rise you up and you will take your position in the name of Jesus. Cast not away your confidence. Confidence is so important, brothers and sisters. You must hold your confidence everywhere you are. Even when it doesn't make a sense to other people, hold on to your confidence. Continue to confess that Jesus is the Lord. Even when you are on a sick bed, you've lost weight and it's only bones around, cast not away your confidence. Even when everybody has dumped you and they've forgotten about you, you make a call, they don't pick your calls anymore, they seem not to love you anymore, you are useless. Please, when all that is happening, keep one thing: confidence in the Lord. Cast not away your confidence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is that confidence which will take you through all the thin and all the thick, in hell and in grave, in pain, in shame. That confidence you hold on to will take you one day back to your position which God made you for. Somebody say hallelujah. Before I wind up, there is a last part here that you need to hear. It says, cast not away your confidence, which has got a great reward of recompense. Now, the word recompense means compensation. Now, compensation surpasses measures of reward and wages and salaries. You see, compensation is above market value. Let me give you something here. If the government is interested in your property and they are enforced to use it, even against your willing to sell it, if they are going to take it because they are a government, they are not going to ask for the market value. They are going to look for the compensation. All people that have been compensated, they have received many times the original value. People where the roads of UNRWA have passed by, a road reserve which you cannot even construct a small house. If you are fortunate and the road not touches that area, you are not selling, you are going to be compensated. I can tell you something that you couldn't even fetch 2 million, you can end up getting 100. Now capture the same mind. Bring it into the scripture to understand what Paul is saying. Of the people who hold on to their compensation or to their confidence. So he says, you hold it on. Don't cast it away. Because it will be rewarded. In due time, it will be rewarded. Not on a market value, but in a mode of compensation. I have seen people developing estates, and you ask, where did they get money? And then they tell you the people of Mirongoti, the masts, they liked his heel. And therefore, they have compensated him. A man who could not do anything by compensation of a small hill is now a big entrepreneur in housing estate. Let me tell you of everything that you suffer. The shame. The shame, the pain, the rejected that you go through, but you keep hanging and you keep declaring that Jesus is the Lord and He is well able. If you shall hang on to the due time, ladies and gentlemen, what you are going to be rewarded with is going to astound. No. Don't let your confidence. To surroundings. I'm not so confident in the Lord because of the amount of money in the bank. I'm not so confident because of what I already have. You know, many of us, we misinterpret the things of God. Some of us, the level increases because of the achievements we already have. There are people who can sing and dance because they got their salary on time. And if it has delayed, everything goes down and they cast doubt on God. That's not how things of God work. The things of God work when the situation seems contrary. it seems contrary. Yet you take your position. You refuse to accept the negativity. You declare the positivity. You keep moving forward. You ignore the mountain you see. And you see the big God of the mountain. And as you continue like that, the power of God is generated. And you start to see mountains vanishing your way. And you begin to see miracles happening. We must know how the things of God work. Many of us miss to see the miracle power. Because we interpret everything according to the environment. It is well with me because the salary is coming, the profit is coming. Let me tell you, it is even much well when all forces of the devil have turned against you, but God is on your side, because what you will see next is the display of God's power. You are God, and everybody around you will not fail to see the mighty power of God whom you serve. So even when things are going zigzag, cast not your confidence. Shout and say, I will not cast away my confidence in Him. That is a higher level of trust beyond any reasonable doubt. Where they tell you you won't have it, it is gone, they bought it, it is sold, you can't have it. You see, many times in life, there are things you are looking forward to. And you say, if I get this one, I will be well. But your enemy also is reading your mind to see where you have put your confidence and trust. Let me love my job, but my confidence will be in God. I want to get money, but my confidence is in God. Which means even when money fluctuates, I still have confidence in God that I will get the money I want in time. Somebody say hallelujah. Pastor Jen, can we just pray for about 10 minutes? Because we want to build our confidence as children of God. This is a month of prayer. It's not enough just to stay hungry. It's not enough to stay hungry, but not building something to keep with you after even after the
season.
Days of prayer and fasting are numbered. But even when they end, our lives continue. So use